shots at the Junkies. I'm in San Francisco, circa 1990s. It was peaceful then, the world was much less whiny. All read books and conversed at the cafes, and they all went out to the movies. Pre-Twitter shit, no emotion, altering garage technology. Pre-Facebook shit, no mind dummy. Idiocracy, pre-bandwagon shit, no knee-jerk, no triggering arguments about Aziz Ansari's days and the accusations against Morgan Freeman. Homelessness was savvy, you didn't try to erase them from the city's history. Throw names at them that are demoralizing and cruel and derogatory. What's the deal with some needles of land under a pretty palm tree down the street? What's the deal with some bus stops, somebody else's lavatory? All you do is stand and order food from your apps anyway. Potatoes, potatoes, whiny goddamn couch potatoes. Potatoes, potatoes, whiny goddamn couch potatoes. Now you're hijacked by everything that pops up on your phone. You're angry about it for an hour till the news diverts your attention by throwing you another bone. And yeah, you're justified in being angry. The kids are being pulled from their parents at the border. When Obama had illegal immigrants thrown out of the country left and right, y'all thought he was adorable. Made you feel so good to love the smiling, light-skinned black man. But like I said, illegals were being thrown out of the country under him. I wrote a song once for an immigrant years ago who broke the law. He had three kids, he was sent back to Mexico, and his wife and kids didn't even get a phone call. Under Obama, guys were getting sent back to their birthplaces, y'all. Then I sang that song for you, and you requested it at my shows. That song, if you all remember, was called Gustavo. I don't give much thought to Gustavo. To Gustavo, I don't give much thought. You thought the song was funny, you thought the song was sweet, and it was cute. You didn't think about those kids getting pulled from their daddies, much did you? But now your heart's hurting for the kids being pulled from their mommies and daddies, aren't you? Well, it's been happening for years, it's just now the news is finally spinning in a way that alarms you. This agenda promoting the orangutan who came from the zoo. It's gonna be the president again, mark my words, thanks to the news and social media, and thanks to couch potatoes,
hopefully
even human beings to the people who are running the news. Just dollar signs, and you're all just a bunch of junkies sniffing their blue,
sniffing their blue,
sniffing whatever the Anchorman decides to sell you.
Sniffing, sniffing, it's a bunch of goddamn blue.
I'm telling you people, if you keep pecking away at your phones, Donald Duck gonna be in office in 8 years. Cosmic prophecy, Sisters Ambrose, Donald gonna be there two full terms, that's for sure. So are the San Francisco homeless, and so are the Tenderloin pimps and hoes. I don't mind the pimps and hoes and the bums pissing in the alleys, and nobody else did until San Francisco sold its ass to Silicon Valley. Now the rich want to be catered to, they want perfection, they don't want poverty in their streets.
But
the poor gonna stick around, and in time, all the techies gonna retreat. They never gave a fuck about the Golden Gate Bridge, or the beautiful terrain, or about Cafe Trieste, or the hit Ashbury, or the Jefferson Airplane. They'll be packing up and leaving on the Google train. Maybe move to Jellystone Park if we're lucky, and they can cry to Yogi Bear about all their pain. Don't get me wrong, do not think that I don't care. I've employed more illegal immigrants than the average Joe on his lunch break in Union Square. I've given lots of pesos to kids in the streets of Oaxaca, Mexico. I bought their chapulines every morning from their wooden bowls. Me, myself, I got an idea of how this president came to office. People started believing in the predictions of Don Lemon as if he were Nostradamus. People started giving platforms to Pauly D and Paris Hilton. People started believing headlines that was believable as Bigfoot sightings and Rumpelstiltskin. This morning I dreamed that I was with Caroline at a cafe. Somewhere in California, it felt like somewhere in Bolinas. Lots of daylight coming through the windows. There was a band playing in the corner. We met the drummer. He kind of looked like Jack Kilmer. He told us that his brother played a percussive instrument with strings, like guitars.
Like guitars.
They played notes that didn't sustain, but when playing, playing. He told us he was gonna drive someplace nearby to pick up some drumsticks and asked if
you wanna come
to go alone. Caroline said she'd stick around the cafe, but I said I was up for the ride.
It doesn't take too long.
Wouldn't take too long. When we were driving, I asked where his brother lived. He said,
Lompoc.
And I said, actually, I've been there. Does your brother play in the house band at the Lompoc Wine Factory? He said, yes. And I said, well, I think I've seen him play. A long-haired guy. He said, that's him. And he kept on driving and driving, further and further. And I asked him where he was
going.
Where are
we going?
He said, to San Francisco. You said you needed a ride, right? I said, no, man. I thought we were going to your rehearsal space to get some drumsticks. Right? He said, no, I'm heading to San Francisco. I thought you said that's where you live. I said,
I do,
but hold on, stop the car. Tell me where we are, you Jack Kilmer-faced kid. He pulled over and I called Caroline and told her where I was. She dropped me off on the side of the road somewhere in Northern California and I waited for Caroline to pick me up. And I woke up from the dream and I walked down to Aquatic Park. I looked out into the fog, soaking up the air. I could barely see Tiburon. Fishermen were fishing on the east side of the pier. Every day it's my pleasure to walk out here. Three seals poke their heads up from the water. These beautiful things are why I moved here. A man was giving sailboat lessons to a younger man, and from there I walked to the Levi's store and bought a warmer jacket. Nathan overslept and I went and knocked on his hotel door, past the City Lights bookstore at the North Beach Hotel. I waited for him down in the lobby, watched a young girl ask the lady at the front desk if she knew how to get to Yosemite. Nathan and I went and ate sandwiches at Molinari. And we went to City Lights and I talked to one of the employees about the book, about the boxer from Modesto, Fat City. And I bought the book called Anti-Social Media, How Facebook Undermines Democracy. Told the staff how I was gonna post a photo of the book on my social media pages. And one of them said, that's funny. Nathan and I went to Trieste, I got an iced tea, he got a coffee. I said to the guy, I see you starting the day with the music of Air Supply. On the walk back I pointed to the mural of Paul Canton, past City Lights again, and the storefront was boasting a huge selection of Bukowski. We walked up through Chinatown, through Jack Hill and Alley, bought some cucumbers and some blueberries. Everything was harmonious and merry. We walked past Le Hong Lounge and I thought of the chopped dumplings that are always delicious and savory. Everything reminded me of what it was about the city that first spoke to me. And as we approached High Street Studios, the Tenderloin homeless were as they've always been, minding their own. And I sang about everything leading up
to waking up and walking to a crowded park. All of that must have been sparked by articles my friend had sent me, with sensational headlines and attention-grabbing quotes like, medical convention relocated from San Francisco to LA because doctors are scared. Last year at the same convention, somebody's purse was stolen. I'm from a third world country and San Francisco is worse. Noe Valley shocked and disgusted by the homeless. Middle-aged tech guy is angry because he saw feces on the street corner once. I don't know what it is that they see or feel. I told a man there are places for people who can't hack the city. They are called suburbs, Trapanoa, or Antioch, or Hercules. All I know is this morning I saw seagulls flying above me, and from there the day moved along peacefully. And here in the studio, I'm singing tunefully to the music of Jim and Donnie and me, joyfully. We took a break, went out for dinner. Waitress asked the guy at the table how I was doing. Said the world's all messed up, but me, I'm doing fine.